Welcome students. In the previous session, we discussed trial balance, objective, methods, and we started the discussion on types of error. In today's session, we are going to discuss in detail all the types of error. Let's start with our first error, error of commission. These are the errors committed by the staff of organization, mostly affecting the trial balance. These are of the following types. First, wrong posting of the transaction. Second, wrong totaling of an account. Next, wrong balancing of an account. Next, wrong casting of subsidiary books. Casting means totaling. Next, wrong recording in the books of original entry, etc. These kind of errors affect the trial balance. For example, if an entry is recorded correctly in the sales book, but while recording in the customer account, we posted a wrong amount. Now, it will affect the trial balance, since it is affecting one side of the trial. But if we record in the sales book wrongly and also post it wrongly, then it will not affect the trial balance, because both the aspects are wrong. And when debit is wrong, credit is wrong, trial will tally, although it is wrong, but it will tally. Now, though both are commission errors, similarly, wrong balancing or wrong totaling will lead to a single sided error and thereby affecting the accuracy of trial balance. That is, it will not tally. Now, these errors are also known as clerical errors. Now, while doing the practical question, we will discuss other type of error also. Now, coming to the second type of error, error of omission. It is committed at recording level or posting level. Now, it can be full omission or partial omission. In case of full omission, both the aspects are missing, debit and credit, then trial will tally. But in case of partial omission, like you have recorded one aspect debit and forgotten second aspect credit, or you have recorded credit and forgotten debit, in that case trial will not tally. So, in case of full omission, trial will tally, but partial one not tally. As one sided error always result in trial balance thrown out of order. Next, error number 3 is error of principle. In this type, we either ignore or violate some accounting principle, which result in an error. It can be due to the capital expense being taken as revenue. Like you have made some addition in the building and you have treated it as repair, it has to be taken as building account, but you have taken it as repair. So, building was a capital expense and you have wrongly treated as revenue expense. So, it will reduce our profit also. Similarly, if we treat personal account as nominal or real account as personal and so on, these all will be treated as error of principle. For example, if we pay salary and debit the worker personal account instead of nominal account salary, we are debiting worker personal account. Now, this is an error of principle. Similarly, if we recover some old bad debts, that is bad debt recovered, and put it in the personal account of that person, now it is again treating nominal as personal. But these errors are not going to affect the trial balance, because debit is recorded in debit and credit is recorded in credit. Arithmetical accuracy is always there, but you know, actually overall it is not correct, but arithmetical accuracy, trial balance proves only arithmetical accuracy, so which is there. Now, coming to the last error, that is compensating error. It is a very difficult error to find out. Now, it means the effect of two errors in such a way that debit mistake of let us say 5000 is compensated by another error of 5000 in some account somewhere in credit. So, both mistakes are of 5000, one in debit, one in credit. Now, to detect this will be a mammoth task, as trial is tallied, very difficult to find out. Now, before proceeding on as to how to rectify these errors, we must first know how to find out these errors, because unless you know what is the mistake, how will you correct it? So, let us first discuss those errors which will affect the trial balance. As soon as we see that trial is not tallied, we follow these steps. First, we retotal all the debit and credit columns. Second, then we compare the account heads in the ledger and the trial to detect if there is any omission. Next, point number 3, then we compare the trial balance of current year with the previous year to check whether there is any addition, deletion, and particularly when very large or unexpected. Next point, then we check the correctness of posting from the original books, cash book, journal proper, all these original books we check. Then in the next step, if still errors are there, we check the totaling of all the accounts again, and if still there is a difference, then first we find out the exact amount of difference. Now, I am coming to tell you a very interesting observation. If the amount of difference is in thousands, hundreds or tens, or divisible by 2 or 9, we take one by one. First, if the difference is in thousands, hundreds or tens, then generally it is a case of totaling error or mistake in carry forward of the remainder, hasil, remainder. Second, if the difference is divisible by 2, generally it means that some credit item is written in the debit column, or vice versa, like debit is written in the credit. And if the difference is divisible by 9, then look for transposition of figures. Transposition means, for example, 2536 written as 2356. See the difference between them. This is 180 and it is divisible by 9. Now, a question can arise in your mind: is it always like this? And the answer is a big yes. Try some example at home. Okay, see, transposition of figures always divisible by 9. This is a very great thing. Do it at home. Let's do some brainstorming exercise. We will tell you some errors and you have to think as to which are these type of errors. I am telling you the first point. Purchase of furniture recorded as purchase. Which kind of error is this? Yes, principal error. Come to the next one. Cash received from Sonu recorded as Monu. Which kind of error? Sonu, Monu. Yes, it is commission error, committed mistake. Next one, cash sales not recorded in the cash book. Now, this is full omission. You have not recorded in the cash book, so it means it will not be posted in the ledger also. Next one, overcasting of purchase book. Overcasting means over totaling of the purchase book. Which kind of error is this? Yes, commission error. Next, sale to X, credited to his account. Now, when you sell to X, you have to debit. Now, you have credited. Which kind of error? No. It is not principal, it is commission. Because you have just written X instead of debit to the credit. Nothing else. Next one, sale of car recorded as sales, whereas it should be written as asset sale, and you have recorded as normal sale. So, this is an error of principal. Now, let us do some multiple choice question also. Question number 1, if a trial balance agrees, it means A part, there is no error, B part, single sided error, C part, double sided error, or D part, both type of error, single and double. Now, yes, the answer is double sided error, because in case of single side error, trial balance will not agree. So, it is the answer double sided error. Next one, if wages are paid for installation of machinery and you recorded it as wages, which kind of error it is? Yes, it is a principal error, because wages paid for machine should be added in the machine, not as revenue expense wages. Next question, which of the following do not affect the trial balance? First, complete omission of an entry, you think. Second, error of principal. Next, posting on the correct side, debit or credit, but in a wrong account, say for example, Ram instead of Sham, but on the right side. And the last option is all of the above. It is a tricky question, think carefully. I am repeating it. Which do not affect the trial? First, complete omission, error of principal, posting on the correct side, but in a wrong account, or all of the above? The answer is all of the above, because complete omission will make the trial balance tally. Error of principal, you have written in debit and credit, it will also be tallied. And the next one, you have posted on the correct side, the name may be different, but debit is in debit, credit is in credit, so it will tally the trial. Next question, sales to Ram, 3500, posted in his account as 350. This is an error of omission, commission, compensating, principal. Yes, it is commission error. Next question, choose the correct statement. I will give you 3 statements. Think carefully. First, totaling error is a principal error. Next, compensating error affect the trial balance. Next, principal error do not affect the trial balance. Yes, this third one is right. So, this is the correct statement, principal error do not affect the trial balance. So, my dear students, this brings us to the end of today's session. In this session, we have discussed the type of errors in detail, steps to locate the errors, and some brainstorming questions. In our next session, we are going to start with the practical question on rectification as to how to rectify these kind of errors. Like if there is an error of omission, how will you correct it? Practically, which entry you will write, what is the right entry, what is the wrong entry, how to rectify. Till then, please learn these points. Thank you very much.